say that when I have been on merit review panels, looking at the knowledge translation component, and I have heard the feedback from from the panel in terms of expectations about what the KT plan should look like, I guess there's a part of me, that thinks, okay, not everything. Like, we will exhaust ourselves, people, if every single one of these research projects has to have this incredibly extensive KT plan where they're going to have, you know, these documents going out here and these sessions here and these meetings here and these. And I mean, just from the perspective of fatigue and also practicality, I don't know that every research project deserves to get, you know, a lot of KT.
Not all of them. Appropriate.
Assuming exactly that it's
entirely
appropriate.
Entirely agree with you.
That's right.
Not everything is ready for KT.
That's right.
Or is appropriate.
That's right. I am and I am much more, and I know this isn't appropriate in some cases, but I'm definitely much more a fan of let's pull out all the stops for knowledge translation when we're talking about evidence synthesis. Great. Mm-hmm. When we're talking about that we've looked at all those 300 studies and we've sorted out what was good and what was mediocre and we've really pulled the gems and we've got a clear message, then let's really make a strong effort to get that out to people who could do something with it. But for individual studies, I think we may have gone too far in some places because the expectations on researchers for a grant that's $50,000 or $125,000 for some, I don't know, it just in some cases it seems excessive.
And I think as funders, we've reacted to this call for return on investment, and we have really done a disservice to the whole knowledge translation enterprise.